Very good. Yes.
Narayan Singh Deo.
Delivery
and what facts?
Okay.
Waiting for the mic. दूसरा इनिशिएटिव था सर इस बार थोड़ा पीछे रह गया थैंक यू सर डेप्टी स्पीकर सर सर वी हैव रिसीव रिपोर्ट्स ऑफ द डाइल्यूशन ऑफ द एमएनआरईजीए देयर आर रूमर्स दैट अ सर्कुलर हैज गॉन टू स्टेट्स व्हिच सीक्स टू लिमिट द स्कीम अप टू 200 डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स एंड चेंज द लेबर एंड कैपिटल रेशियो एसेट रेशियो इन दैट मटीरियल रेशियो थैंक यू Sir, I have also got, I have seen some news reports of a statement made by the minister where he claims to deny this. So what the minister's position will obviously be apparent when he answers to this 193. However, sir, I speak of the mood of the BJP that I have seen. Our young friend recently spoke about Hukum Deo Yadav ji and his comments and the comments of some other members who are aligned with the NDA. So these comments tend to lean towards criticizing the NREGA, saying that there is corruption which exists in the NREGA. Hukum Deo ji also said that it raised the minimum wage of agricultural labor, thereby impacting adversely agriculture. Sir, all of these, while holding true, cannot be a reason to dilute the scheme. For the simple reason, sir, if there is corruption in the scheme, should you be removing corruption or should you be stopping the scheme? There was corruption in 2G and 3G. Were telephones banned or was the corruption removed? There was corruption in coal. Were coal mines banned or was the process improved? Similarly, sir, if there's a rise in agriculture wage, is that a good thing or a bad thing? The government seeks to, the Prime Minister himself made a statement about Jan Dhan Yojana, saying so many people have been included in the financial sector. And now, sir, they say that if there's an increase in agricultural wages, it's bad in some way. If agriculture is suffering, it's not because of increase in agriculture wages, it is suffering because of poor and faulty, consecutive poor and faulty policies of the government of India. The problem with agriculture is very different. We all know there are small holdings, they don't have access to finance, they don't get access to markets, they don't get no access to real-time information. Solve those problems. Do not deny the poor agricultural labor who does not have any other option of putting food on his plate by diluting MNREGA. Sir, one of the good things that the previous government did was to have a rights-based approach. Previously, governments have been functioning under Maibab Sarkar. If you want something from the government, you have to either touch the feet of the MP or the MLA or the collector. It's a politics of patronage. The good thing the previous UPA government did was to enact many guarantee schemes, food guarantee, employment guarantee. It's a rights-based approach. The people have a right to demand 100 days work and the government has to provide it or give them money. That brings to account the performance of this government or any government for that matter. If the government does not perform, they become financially liable and maybe even at some point of time politically liable. So if we are going to limit them to 200 districts, it doesn't make sense because where there are poor, lesser poor people, the demand will be less. But yet those poor people have a right. This rights-based approach should not be taken away. I have seen replication of this Maibab Sarkar coming in after the new government has taken over. I certainly hope there are some people amongst the ministers, amongst the cabinet, who recognize that India has is evolved to become a more becoming a developing nation, and part of that development should be to provide the people of the country, the citizens of this nation, certain rights rather than have a politics of patronage. Sir, there are many advantages which have come out of this scheme. It's increased social and economic security, especially that of women, because women directly work and get the money in their bank accounts. It doesn't go into the bank accounts of their husbands or the male members of the family. Sir, Hukum Deoji was saying it affects agriculture adversely. He should be knowing, the minister should state that about 80% of the work is done for agriculture purposes. Whether it's regeneration of natural resources, soil, providing small farm ponds. The MORD had commissioned a study to evaluate the performance and impact of NRLG in Chhattisgarh, Odisha, and Jharkhand, and Andhra Pradesh. And all of this particular study revealed there's been an increase in household income, there's been an increase in agriculture wages, there's been a reduction in distressed migration, an issue which is very pertinent to my constituency, the KBK area or Balangir area. Sir, 70% of the work takes place in non-agriculture season. Only 30% takes place in agriculture season. So in reality, what it has done is to give the poor farmers, the poor laborers, an option of getting another 100 days of work. And yes, it has raised the wages in rural area, which in my belief is a good thing. The Honorable Urban Development Minister was just stating that there's a lot of pressure of urbanization on Delhi and other states. And if we remove MNREGA, will the pressure increase or reduce? Won't more people come to Delhi seeking jobs? Should we not be providing them jobs back in their own villages as we were? Sir, the Honorable Finance Minister, in his statement a few days ago, in his budget reply to the budget, made some very detailed comments on MNREGA. Obviously, he has also felt the criticism of this proposal for dilution of MNREGA. He says that he's released somewhere around 25,000 crores, that the budget this time is about 34,000 crores. My friend very correctly put it, with a 7 or 8% inflation, that budget becomes 32,000-33,000 crores, 32,500 crores. It's in fact a reduction. And I can understand the finance minister's problem. He wants to control fiscal deficit, which is a good thing. But sir, reducing MNREGA is not the answer. MNREGA represents a mere 0.3% of the entire budget of GDP. I have information that with a study being undertaken, that more than 9% is given as direct and indirect subsidies or non-merit subsidies. That means to the rich, which gets wasted, which goes to people who don't deserve it. Cut those out. Why cut a genuine scheme which provides employment to the people in the rural areas? Sir, he states that he's given 25,000 crores. My information is that up till 31st September, the six-month period, only 13,000 crores were released to the states. However, I do not want to say that he's wrong. Maybe he may have released some more money to some states beyond that. So last year, 24,000 crores were released by the previous government in the same period. 13,000 crores released by this government. Let us assume that even after that he sent some money. I would like to quote to you from information I've received from the state government of Odisha, which have asked for 1,800 crores, 1,834.36 crores as the total budget for MNREGA in Odisha. However, they have so far received just 1,035.3 crores. So the problem is, when money comes sparingly in spread out allocations, the work cannot happen in spread out allocation. It's a demand-based scheme. There's a lot of paraphernalia around it. You have to get laborers to apply for this scheme. You have to make a list of them. There's a proper process which is followed so it removes leakages in the system. Now, this is a continuous process. For the first few months, they'll give some money, then they'll stop for 4 months. Work has happened, laborers are screaming for money there. Work comes to a halt. In Odisha right now, we have no money, and I repeat, no money in the SCGF and EFMS account since 15th October 2014. Sir, a mere 81 crore was received in the last week of November. That is it. The fact that you are maybe not revising a budget to cut down the expenditure on MNREGA, but in fact you are squeezing the entire scheme by not releasing timely money. It's the same thing. While on paper you are saying you are giving 34,000 crores, by not giving money correctly, by not giving money in time, you are in fact reducing the actual expenditure on MNGRES, because you need 100 days for laborers to work. You need time to prepare these entire projects. That will not be able to happen, because at the end they will say, we are ready to give you money. However, most states will not be able to spend the money. Sir, there are many issues with the MNREGA. Some of my friends might say it's political, that Odisha is not getting it because they are in opposition to the central government. But sir, I have letters from here written from Bihar government, which was once an ally of theirs. I have a letter written from government of Chhattisgarh, which has an NDA ruling chief minister. And even he says he is not getting sufficient money. I do not understand why the government wants to cut down an MNREGA. शायद आपके पास पैसा ना हो, शायद आपके पास इच्छा ना हो, ये भी पक्का हो सकता है। Demand is there, sir. The demand is there. However, what we find that there's a lack of political will. There's a lack of political will by the government, by the NDA government, in fulfilling the demands of the poor and downtrodden of the rural India. They work very well in promoting their relationship with other countries, ensuring their big ticket investments come in, big infrastructure comes in, big business grows. But the fact that there are poor people who realize, for them MNREGA is like God. Hukumdev ji bolte hai ye bhagwan hai ki kya hai, jisko do vakti roti nahi milti hai uske liye iski bhagwan zarur hota hai, aur unke bhagwan ko aap chheenne ja rahe ho. Main guzarish karunga sir, main nivedan karunga aapke through ki mantri sahab, not only does he explicitly clearly state that he will carry on with this scheme, the fact that he will not change the material and component ratio, labor ratio, but also sir, he will tell us today that he will give a timely and time-bound payment and sufficient payment to meet the demands of various states in India. Okay. Thank you. Sri.